to change the world, we should look to the next generation. Our next guest is getting that generation prepared by teaching them sustainable urban farming right here in New York City schools, which is incredible. She's the executive director of New York Sunworks, and she's helped to build hydroponic gardens in hundreds of classrooms. That makes her best in class, y'all. Let's welcome Manuela. Give it up, y'all.
Thank you.
No, I am so stoked. My entire crew knows I am so happy you're here. I talk about this all the time, and it's so important that you're getting into the classrooms and teaching the younger generation, because I wish somebody would have done that with me. But this actually was all inspired by your own kids, right?
Yes, yes, of course. My kids and their friends and their generation. So, yeah. You know, I'm originally from Bolivia, born and raised in Bolivia.
Beautiful.
I did my graduate education here in the States, and a few years after I came back to the States with my husband and two children to New York City. Yeah. And, you know, eventually they started, they were in age to go to school, and they attended public school. They went to PS333, the Manhattan School for Children. Mm-hmm. And when they, you know, were going to school, I was struck really by the fact that there was not that much science, and also no connection to sustainability content, neither climate education.
Yeah.
So I started looking, you know, we need to do something about it. And that's when I learned about this wonderful project and this person, Ted Kaplow, who had created a project called the Science Barge. Which is
so cool.
I agree. Very, very cool.
Yeah. On the Hudson, right?
Exactly.
On the Hudson, it's like a farm, like out on the water, right?
Exactly.
Yes.
So a prototype of an urban farm, exactly, as you see it. All hydroponic and aquaponic technology within this greenhouse.
Self-sustaining,
Correct, using renewable energy as well as rainwater for the technology.
Which is how all of gardening should be at this point. Like, we're smart enough to know better. Yeah,
I think so. So that was the first time New York City was seeing this type of technology and this idea. That was the future of farming.
Yeah.
So when I saw that, I had to meet Ted and met him. And that's when, you know, the dots connected and we started the program with the idea to bring this to the schools so it really becomes a classroom.
Explain what you did in that class, because then it blossomed.
Right, correct. Yeah. So after, you know, we started connecting with Ted, we designed the first classroom and we brought this to PS333, but we ended building a 1,400 square foot rooftop greenhouse.
Yes.
That became,
which could be the food they're growing for the kids.
Exactly, exactly. And most importantly, there you go.
This is what, pesticides, no GMOs, that's amazing.
Nothing.
Yeah.
Exactly. But then, you know, there were enormous amounts of food that we were growing, several harvests a year. So we were feeding the community, but we were also donated to food pantries and
it's incredible because everybody says there's a loss, there's food deserts, and it's like, oh my God, there's no need for a food desert with technology these days and how much you can grow.
Exactly.
You know,
exactly. There's no need for food
deserts. There's no need for that. Yeah. So this was just the start. So what happened after that one classroom?
Yes. Well, with this success, you know, it turned into a hub for the city. We were training other teachers, showing other communities this is possible, and there was an enormous interest from many other schools.
Mm-hmm.
So we were able to build another greenhouse at PS 84, Jose de Diego in Brooklyn. It was a big effort, but at the same time, we realized that it's a big investment. We would not be able to build a rooftop greenhouse in every school.
Yeah.
Therefore, we designed what we call the classroom conversion, and that's where the hydroponic classrooms were, you know, came in into an offer. So now we can transform any classroom into a hydroponic science lab.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Yes. And most of them are Title I schools, right? Like a high percentage, right?
Correct. So 80% of our partners are Title I schools, which means we are in communities, the underserved communities, where not only the project is needed as a science component that we bring into the schools, but also the food production becomes very important.
Yeah.
So we grow hundreds of pounds of vegetables in every classroom, and that's distributed among the community.
Which is so brilliant. It's like I grew up, we didn't have any money, and knowing how to grow your own food and knowing how to do, like, that saves. Like, going to the grocery store is like, you spend so much money, and it's like to teach them, you know, how to grow their own and have a self-sustaining environment in their own household, no matter what your household looks like, is just such an incredible gift.
And that's very important for the students to know.
Joining us now are two of the students. Say hi to fifth graders, Gio and Zoe.
So it's great to meet you both. So what's your favorite part of what you do in the classroom with this?
Well, my favorite part, Kelly, is is that learning how to plants grow and learning all the systems. Some of the systems are the NFT system,
yeah,
the VCS system, and the tower system.
Yeah, God, you sound brilliant. I'm like, what? Way to go. So you like to try the food, right, Zoe?
Yeah.
You like, yeah, to taste test everything? Mm-hmm. That's my favorite part, too. Yeah. What's your favorite thing, like, to grow?
Sorrel.
Sorrel? I know, so I have never actually had sorrel. I heard that this was your... What does it taste like?
It tastes lemony. You would think it tastes like lettuce, but it doesn't.
Yeah. Isn't that shocking when you put them in and they're all like little green and then you're like, wait, that tastes like pepper. Or that tastes like... It's always different. I think it's fascinating. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. Well, earlier, Manuela told us about the nutrient film systems that New York Sun Works provides for schools. And we have a version right here. So what do we have growing in here? Who wants to tell me? Go ahead.
Well, we have here growing basil. And you know what you could grow with basil? Pizza.
Oh, you can make it, yes. Pizza's like my favorite.
So whenever I get a chance to,
You put it on the pizza for garnish, yeah.
So whenever I bring home basil and tomatoes, you know what my dad makes? Pizza.
Pizza. Got an awesome dad. That's, well, explain the system we're looking at.
Okay.
So.
Oh, go ahead, Gio. Oh. Yeah.
Oh, so we're looking at an NFT system, and the system, look, there would be water, so, and it goes around and then spills out and then it just recycles the water.
Yeah. So can people create these kinds of systems like in their home?
Right.
Because exactly. I know they sell several different kinds, but in case they just want to make it, like a DIY.
Correct. So in the market there's plenty, but you can make your own. So this is a very simple system that we brought here.
Like PVC pipe, yeah.
Correct. You can buy PVC pipe. There's a lot online. You can Google and see how to do a DIY, but you know, you just can... Simple materials, and you can use a lot of recycled materials, containers mm-hmm. that you have at home. That's a very, very easy way to design your own systems. By the way, the kids in the classroom also design their own systems, so that's part of the learning process.
I love that. And then with like fresh, like a fresh look, like from a young mind to see what they would create.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So much innovation, you know, and while
Because there's no limits when you're that young. You're like, well, why can't I do this?
Right.
Or why can't I do that? You know, they're not jaded yet.
Correct.
So, I mean, none of us are.
Right.
Scholastic believes that kids have the power to change the world, which is why when they heard about New York Sun Works' amazing success in providing children with quality climate education, they wanted to help you do more. So they're going to donate $5,000 to help out. And I love what you're doing. This is my... favorite segment in a very long time. So I'm gonna add 5,000 as well. I'm gonna double it to give y'all $10,000 out, but I know it's expensive to get these in classrooms, it's expensive to raise money, but it's very cool what you're doing.